In this video, I'm just going to go over the Shimano Di2 shift modes, Semi-Synchro shift mode and Full-Synchro shift mode, how to know which of the shift modes you're in, and how to change modes. In order to check and switch the Shimano Di2 shift modes, you want to look at these LEDs here. So all I'm going to do is press one of the shift levers and hold it down for a half a second. First, we're going to get the battery indicator, and then we're going to get the shift indicator. So how to quickly determine what shift mode you're in on your Di2 shifters, you have two LEDs down here. This left-hand light first comes on to show your battery status. There's a little battery indicator here. So you press it for a half a second. That's a flashing green. That's telling me I'm between 50 and 75%. But right after the green light goes, then both lights will either flash or come on solid. Okay, so if you press your shifter and you get a battery light and then you get the red and green both solid for 2 seconds, that means you're in manual mode. Now I just switched it to semi-synchro. So when you press your button, battery indicator, and then it flashes twice, both LEDs flash twice, that means you're in semi-synchro. And I am now changing it to full synchro mode. So if you press your lever, hold it, get your battery indicator, and then it flashes, both lights flash 3 times, that means you're in full synchro mode. And to change between modes, it cycles from one mode to the next. So you just have to click this button 2 quick times. It's kind of like a mouse click. You got to do it 2 quick times in succession, and it moves on to the next mode. So if I click it again, 2 flashes, that means I'm in semi-synchro. Click it again, 3 flashes, that means I'm in full synchro. 2 more clicks, and I'm back to manual mode. So that's how you change the modes. So what do the modes mean exactly? In semi-synchro mode, whenever you change from the large chainring in the front to the small chainring in the front, the Shimano Di2 will automatically compensate for that big jump in gears by moving the chain 2 gears higher on the rear. And vice versa, when changing from the small chainring to the large chainring, the Di2 will automatically compensate in the other direction. So let me show what happens here. So we're on the big chain ring. I'm going to move to the small chain ring. And you'll notice in the back, it jumped 2 gears to compensate. Now we're going to do the same. I'm going to move from the small chain ring to the large chain ring. And in the back, it compensated by moving the chain up 2 gears. Okay, in full synchro mode, right now we're in a very low gear. And all you need to do is use the rear derailleur to move the chain to harder gears, and as you do that, when the chain gets to the third to the hardest gear, it's automatically going to shift your front derailleur to the larger chain ring, and at the same time it's going to compensate by moving the rear derailleur back up 2 gears to avoid that big jump in gears again. So let me show you what that looks like. So right now, we're in the easiest gear, large chainring in the back, small chainring in the front. And I'm just going to use the rear derailleur and change the cogs one by one. And it's going to get increasingly harder. When it gets to about the third from the hardest gear, the front derailleur is automatically going to shift the chain to the large chainring. And at the same time, it's going to compensate in the rear by moving the chain back up 2 cogs. So let's watch that happen. So right here, it makes the change. And you see where we're at in the back. And you just continue. Now we're going to go in the opposite direction. We're in the hardest gear right now. We're just going to one by one, using the rear derailleur only. Let me slow the wheel down a little bit. Using the rear derailleur only, we're going to move to easier gears, and then on the next gear change, the front chain ring is going to automatically move to the smaller chain ring in the front. Like that, and then it compensates by moving the chain back 2 gears. And as we continue to press the rear derailleur, it gets to the easier gears. So it just saves you a bunch of steps as you go through your gears.
Thanks for watching the video. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments section below. And please subscribe.